Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at using categories in numbers. Now, categories are a way for you to better organize the rows in your spreadsheet. Like, for instance, let's take this sample spreadsheet here with a bunch of items you can find at a grocery store. And you can see that in addition to the item name and cost, we've got type and on sale and date received. And type, you can see, is organized into three different categories. Now, if I wanted to put, say, all the fruits and all the vegetables together, one thing I could do is I could sort by this column. But say I don't want to sort by this. Say, for instance, this is in a specific order, and I don't want to actually change the entire order of the table just to get that. But I do want to group things together by type. Well, I can do that by introducing categories. So one way to do that is to actually select the entire row there and go to the top here and say I want to categorize by this column. Simple as that. If I do that, you can see now it breaks everything up by fruit, vegetable, nut, and it puts them all together. They're in the order inside here that they were originally, but now they're grouped together in these various categories. And the neat thing about these categories is, of course, I can tweak them to say close each one and only focus on a single category. It's very useful if you have an extremely large table and you just want to focus on one. And likewise, you can hit the Option key and close them all and then open one up. So it makes it very easy to group them together and focus on one type. Now I can easily turn this off by selecting here and say, you know, delete the categories, and the categories are gone. Another thing I can do is I can use multiple categories. So I can say, let's categorize by this column, and then let's also inside that categorize by the on sale column. And now you can see I've got categories inside of categories. So under fruit, I've got those on sale and those not on sale. And I can reverse the order of these several different ways. One, of course, easy way to do it would be to delete the categories and start again. Here I'm just going to delete that one and then add it back in, and now you can see it's reversed. I have everything on sale and then by category, and everything not on sale and then by category. So you can group them as deeply as you want. Now another way to set up categories is to use the Reorganize panel. So let's get rid of the categories here and then go to the Reorganize panel here. And using that, I can choose a column here for categories and say I'm going to choose the type. And it'll add it. And you can see it made the changes to the table there. And then I can also go and choose, say, on sale. And it'll just simply change that. But if I want to add, I can do on sale. Now you can see I've added that. And I've got it what like I had before. But I can also reorganize these by using these little arrow buttons here to change which order they're in. Now let's say instead of by type, I want to do it by date received. So you can see now I've got it broken up into different days. I'm using this column, column F here. I can also tell it I don't want it broken up by days. I want it by unique values, so exactly what is in there. But I can also do it by weeks, and it's smart enough to figure out which week each date it is in and put everything in appropriately. And you could do it by other things like months, quarters, and years as well. Now you could also create categories without even having a column. So one thing you can do is you can go into your list here and say in a row that you want to start, I want this row to start a new category. I can click the button here to the left side of the row and I can say insert category. And what it's going to do is it's going to start a new category at that row. So everything before it is in this first category and everything after it's in the second category. And you can see it actually created a new column for me at the end there that included these new items. Now here's a cool thing. You say, well, God, I don't want to call it item one. I want to call it something else. So you can go and change each one of these individually, but you can also go over here and with categories you can make one change. It's going to change everything over here on the in the column to reflect it. So I could do the same thing, say, if I had the categories, say, fruit, vegetable, nut, I could change it. So I could just change the word vegetable to something shorter very easily by categorizing it and changing it on the left, and then it would change it in the column here in every one where the word vegetable appears. Now you can also create a category by selecting rows. So for instance, I'll select it's like rows 2 to 5, and then I can click this button here that appears on the left side and say create a category from the selected rows, and those rows are chosen. Or I can select discontinuous rows, so this one here, and I'm going to hold down Command and select this one and this one here. Sorry, there you go. So I'm going to select several rows by holding the Command key down and then select any one of those and say create categories from the selected rows, and it will grab those rows, put them out there, and create the column over here that has this new category name. Now let's go back to our original arrangement here. We've got us categorized by type and then by whether or not it's for sale. And it can be hard to kind of read this. But what you can do is you can select any one of these category heads here. So I'm going to do the type here, just select by selecting fruit. And I can actually change, say, the font to bold. And you can see it's going to do it for each one of those in each category. I can change the color. I can change the font size. I can even bring up the inspector here and go under cells and change the cell background color to something. So make it kind of a gray. And you can see it does it for the entire row across, and now I can more easily see my categories. I could do the same thing for these, for instance. I just change this to a color so that I can easily see these inside of here. And going back to that reorganize panel, one of the neat things about it is you can turn on and off the categories. So for instance, if I want to view them like this sometimes, I just have it on and then I uncheck it and now it goes back to the regular format. So I can enter more data in, go back to my reorganized table, and I can turn it back on. And you can see it remembers my settings here when I turned it on and off. It doesn't delete them, so it's very easy to switch it on and off and basically think of it as having two different modes as looking at this table. So there's a look at using categories and numbers. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. And go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.